In this video, I will show you how to sprout Nepenthes Edwardsiana seeds. How's it going, guys? Welcome back. Today I'm very excited about this video because if you know me for a long time, you may already know that the plants that got me started into tissue culture were carnivorous plants. And I have a Jeff Schaefer, aka Nepenthes God, send me some Nepenthes Edwardsiana seeds. So today I will show you how to sprout them and to get it into tissue culture. So let's get started. So you already know I had to run an experiment. So I placed one seed into each of these test tubes and I have labeled them A, B, C, D. Each of these will be a different sterilizing solution. So the first one is going to be hydrogen peroxide. And what I do is I take one part hydrogen peroxide and nine parts water. And that's going to be my first sterilizing solution. I also add one drop of polysorbent 20. This is going to be my surfactant, so the seeds have better contact with the sterilizing solution. My second sterilizing solution or agent is going to be sodium dichloro. So the sodium dichloro, to make it, and first I need to make a solution. So what I do is that I take one in 100 milliliters of water, I measure 0.1 grams of the sodium dichloro, agitate until everything has been dissolved, and then I take the 2 milliliters that I need to sterilize all of my seeds. Next is something that I'm using for the first time, is hypochlorous acid. And what I'm doing is I'm taking one part hypochlorous acid to three parts of water. And lastly is the classic 10% bleach solution. So one part of bleach and nine parts of water. And I also add the surfactant to every single one of these solutions to make sure I have a good contact with the seeds and with the sterilizing agent. Next, I will add the sterilizing solution to each of my tubes. So I want to start with solution A, or the hydrogen peroxide. So I use my micropipette to add 0.2 microliters of the hydrogen peroxide solution to the first set of tubes. For the second set of tubes, it will be the sodium dichloro. So I do the same thing, 0.2 milliliters to each of these test tubes. Third is going to be the hypochlorous acid, the same thing, 0.2 milliliters. So the way that I'm doing this is in a way where I start with the one that it needs the most time. So the hydrogen peroxide is going to take just over an hour. The sodium dichloro is going to take between like closely around 40, 45 minutes. The hypochlorous acid around 30 minutes. And for the bleach is the one that is the strongest one. It only takes 12 minutes to sterilize the seeds. I'm doing this for time efficiency. So the first seeds that I'm ready are the ones that I did last. So the ones with the bleach. So what I'm doing now is that I'm getting rid of all the bleach and using my micropipette. You see, I'm sucking all the bleach out of the tubes, being careful not to suck the seed as well, because the seeds are fairly small. And then after that, I add in the sterile water, and I want to rinse the seeds three times. Each rinse is going to be for only 3 minutes. And then after that, I will repeat the same thing with the hypochlorous acid and then the sodium dichloro. And for the hydrogen peroxide, I don't have to rinse the seed. This is only for the first three sterilizing solutions. Hydrogen peroxide, no need to sterilize or to rinse the seeds. After rinsing the seeds, then it's time to move them into media. So what I have two experiments again. So I have a media with charcoal and media with no charcoal. The media is the same. The only difference is the charcoal. So it is a 1/3 MS media. Nepenthes doesn't like a lot of nutrients, so I'm only using 1/3 of the strength. And there is no hormones on this media. I want it to be hormone free because the seeds, they don't actually need the hormones. We add the hormones after the plants have grown a little bit, and then there is time for use the hormones for multiplication. So what I'm doing this is adding to every single of my test tubes. I have them all labeled, and all I have to do now is wait until they sprout and see the results. And here are my Nepenthes Edwardsiana seeds in the test tubes. All I have to do is wait until they sprout. Thanks again to Jeff or Nepenthes God for sending me these seeds. Make sure to check his website, Nepenthes God. For Nepenthes, these are seeds that they can take a little while to sprout. So for this, according to his experience, to Jeff's experience, is they will take maybe 3-4 weeks to start sprouting. However, with my experience also working with some Nepenthes seeds in the past, in tissue culture, they can take all the way until like maybe 6 months to sprout. So we'll see what happens. Very excited. I'm running, like I say, running different experiments. So let's see what works the best. So let me know down in the comments which method you think is going to work the best. I think I will see you make an update maybe in about a month to see what has worked. So I have a hydrogen peroxide, sodium dichloro, hypochlorous acid, and bleach. So let's see what method works the best. Now I want to make a disclaimer. This is an experiment. So before starting doing this or before starting using any of these methods, please wait until the part two of this experiment where I show you the results so you know which method worked the best, so you don't have to waste on materials, maybe time, maybe some of these may end up killing the seeds. We don't know. Like I say, this is like an experiment. I know the hydrogen peroxide method works. I also know the bleach method works, but it also very strong, so it may end up damaging some of the seeds. So that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to find different sterilization methods, see what works the best, and we'll see where it goes. So I hope you have enjoyed it, and then I will see you next time, and goodbye. Thanks
for watching the video. If you are enjoying these tissue culture videos, make sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you are interested on conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantsafetechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use code FP10 for 10% off on your first purchase.